Did President Barack Obama free ISIS leader Abu Bakr al-Baghdadi from Gitmo, return him to the Middle East, and allow the ISIS leader into Syria? No, that's not true. Al-Baghdadi was freed from an Iraqi prison after several months in U.S. military custody during President George W. Bush's first term. The future ISIS caliph was considered a low risk and not taken to the U.S. facility for high-risk detainees in Cuba. Contrary to allowing al-Baghdadi to enter Syria, Obama's administration waged a war against ISIS, driving it from Iraq and nearly completing its destruction before the end of Obama's second term. The false claim was made in a meme that began circulating on social media soon after al-Baghdadi was killed in a U.S. raid in Syria on October 26, 2019, including a post published on October 28, 2019. It featured a photo of former President Obama in a thoughtful pose with these words. Quote, "I tried. I did everything I could to save Abu Bakr al-Baghdadi. I freed him from Gitmo. I returned him to the Middle East. I allowed him back in Syria. But Trump killed him anyway." End quote. This is what social media users saw. The memes claim that President Obama freed al-Baghdadi from the U.S. military prison at Guantanamo, Cuba, is false. The future ISIS leader was arrested and imprisoned by American forces in Iraq in 2004, but released after several months when a military review board determined he was not a security risk. This was more than 4 years before Obama took office. An August 2016 Intercept story titled, U.S. Military Now Says ISIS Leader Was Held in Notorious Abu Ghraib Prison, gives the history. Quote, in February 2004, U.S. troops brought a man named Ibrahim Awad Ibrahim al-Badri to Abu Ghraib in Iraq and assigned him serial NH Humber US9IZ157911CI. The prison was about to become international news, but the prisoner would remain largely unknown for the next decade. At the time the man was brought in, Maj General Antonio Taguba was finalizing his report on allegations of abuse at Abu Ghraib's hard site, a prison building used to house detainees singled out for their alleged violence or their perceived intelligence value. Just weeks later, the first pictures of detainee abuse were published on CBS News and in The New Yorker. Today, detainee US9IZ157911CI is better known as Abu Bakr al-Baghdadi, the leader of the Islamic State. His presence at Abu Ghraib, a fact not previously made public, provides yet another possible key to the enigmatic leader's biography and may shed new light on the role U.S. detention facilities played in the rise of the Islamic State. End quote. Contrary to trying to protect al-Baghdadi, Obama announced on September 10, 2014 a systematic, comprehensive and sustained campaign to degrade and ultimately destroy ISIS, which held a large area of territory in Iraq and Syria at the time, according to a Guardian article titled Obama Announces Expanded Airstrikes Against ISIS in Iraq and Syria. Watch the announcement.